My name is Brandon Strilisky, and I'm the head of collections. Yeah, my team and I, we manage and take care of all the fossils in the collection. So from the moment that the material is collected until it comes into here, which is the prepared storage room, or until it possibly heads out on exhibit. So my role begins early on with the design team and trying to figure out what the story is we want to tell and what possible specimens are going to go along with telling that story. One of the really awesome parts of working on this exhibit as well was just trying to decide what was going to make the final cut for remaining on exhibit versus new stuff that we have to put out and show people. So in front of me is a giant bison skull that was out on exhibit for about 30 years. And we decided that it wouldn't make the cut this time. And so we have new specimens that are out there for people to see to really show how large mammals got during the Cenozoic. So if you visit, you'll be able to see the woolly mammoth that remains on exhibit. But this specimen we decided to remove and put some other really cool stuff out there for visitors to see. So the Cenozoic has some really amazing cool specimens that evolved. And some of the mammal forms that appeared in the Cenozoic took some really cool shape. So we have camel, for example, which people don't realize actually evolved in North America first and then traveled to other parts of the world. So we have some of the early camel specimens on exhibit. We also have some really cool large critters, things like called like a meropus, which is this weird sort of elongated neck, almost like a giraffe type animal. Behind me is Archaeotherium, a small carnivore that roamed the Midwest about 30 million years ago. Although it's lovingly referred to as a hell pig, it's actually more closely related to hippos and whales.